Have you ever been troubled by various different interfaces and devices that require dedicated power adapters? In the past, laptops used round charging ports, gaming consoles like PlayStation and Xbox relied on bulky proprietary adapters, and phone charging ports evolved from 30-pin connectors to micro USB and Lightning. Today, a USB Type-C has almost become the universal interface. Whether it's smartphones, laptops, or earbuds, most devices support this standard, making charging more unified and convenient. But does this mean that all DC-powered devices can directly use a Type-C charger? Type-C may seem perfect, but in real-world applications, is it truly plug and play? Is USB PD suitable for all DC appliances? When using a Type-C charger or power bank, have you noticed the PD fast charging label? PD is a power delivery protocol based on USB Type-C that intelligently negotiates the appropriate voltage and current according to the device's needs. This not only improves charging efficiency but also allows users to power multiple devices with just a single Type-C cable, greatly simplifying daily charging challenges. However, when I tried using a PD power bank to supply power to different DC devices, I found that not all of them operated smoothly. You may have encountered similar issues as well. Let's analyze them one by one. Common issues with PD power delivery. Common issues when powering low power DC devices with USB-D are as follows. 1. Different interface specifications. Although USB Type-C has become the mainstream standard, many devices still use other interfaces, leading to compatibility issues. For example, Type-C to USB-A, Type-C to micro USB, and even Type-C to Lightning adapters can help different devices adapt to Type-C power delivery. For special specifications like DC barrel connectors, you can also find corresponding Type-C adapters online to seamlessly connect devices to PD power. 2. Voltage compatibility issue. New PD DC devices negotiate the output voltage with PD chargers or power banks through the handshake protocol. However, older DC devices do not support the PD protocol. In this case, a PD trigger comes in handy. It's a small device that can be connected to a power bank to manually set or fix the output voltage, ensuring the device receives the correct power supply and operates stably. Insufficient power. Even with voltage matching, sometimes devices still cannot operate stably or fail to stop. This could be due to insufficient output power from the PD power supply. The solution is to check the device's power requirements and match it with a PD power supply that provides enough wattage. As long as the PD power supply's output is sufficient and the current meets the demand, power shortages can be avoided. Power bank entering sleep mode. Some power banks automatically enter sleep mode when they detect a low load or when a device remains idle for a long period, leading to a power cut. The solution is to add a small load to keep the power bank continuously detecting current output and preventing sleep mode and ensuring stable device operation. If you've encountered similar issues, feel free to share your experiences in the comments. Case sharing. To address these issues, I will demonstrate the solutions through the following practical cases. Case 1. Router power supply solution. This is a router that requires 120V.8 power supply using the common DC55921 connector. However, it does not support PD protocol, making it incompatible with most PD power banks. Below are the steps to solve this problem. First, you can choose to purchase a Type-C to DC55521 cable to complete the conversion. Next, check if the power bank supports a 120V output setting, which is necessary to supply the router's required voltage. Since the router doesn't support PD protocol, the power bank cannot automatically adjust to the required 120V voltage. A PD trigger is needed to ensure stable power supply. I set the PD trigger to the 120V output setting. This step fixes the power bank's output to the required voltage for the router. Then, connect the output of the PD trigger to the Type-PC to DC55921 cable and plug it into the router. Now the power bank can stably output the correct voltage and current and the router will function properly. Alternatively, you can use a step-up power supply cable to power the router by converting USB-A to DC55921. Case 2. A Starlink Mini Power Supply Solutions. Starlink Mini is a high-performance device with complex power requirements, DC 12V or 24V 60 wattage, PD 20V or 5A 100 wattage. This high power demand presents greater challenges for power banks. First, check if the power bank's PD output supports 20V5A. The power bank must have a 20V setting and provide at least 100 wattage of power. If the power bank does not have a 20V output setting, even with a PD trigger, it cannot overcome the hardware limitations of the power bank itself. Therefore, confirming the PD specifications of the power bank is the first step in solving the problem. If the current power bank cannot meet the Starlink Mini's requirements, consider choosing a power bank that supports true 20V 5A PD output for long-term stable power supply. You can opt for a high-capacity power station that supports 12V or 24V outputs. These devices usually provide multiple voltage settings and have larger capacities, making them perfect for high-power devices. Case 3 true. Apple HomePod Mini Power Supply Solution. The power requirement is 9V, 2.22A, and comes with a Type-C cable. First, check if the power bank's PD output supports 9V and provides at least 20 wattage of power for direct powering. Connect the HomePod Mini's included Type-C cable to the power bank and observe whether it can provide stable power and play music normally. If the HomePod Mini stops playing music or experiences a power cut during playback, it is likely due to the power bank entering sleep mode. This usually occurs when the device's power consumption is below the sleep trigger threshold of the power bank. I plan to connect two power banks to simulate a charging state, preventing the power bank from entering sleep mode due to low power consumption. First, connect two HomePod Mini devices to two power banks. Then, connect the second power bank to the output of the first power bank, allowing the first power bank to charge the second one. This ensures the HomePod Mini runs continuously under various scenarios and provides a stable music playback experience. Of course, if you have other solutions or innovative approaches, feel free to share your experiences in the comments. Conclusions. Through the PD interface of power banks or high-capacity power stations, devices that were originally incompatible with PD power delivery can now be powered. Some older 3C products, which still hold many memories, can be revived through Type-C adapters, allowing these old devices to power up again and extend their value. However, when using these solutions, it's crucial to choose the correct voltage to ensure the devices operate safely and avoid damaging them due to voltage mismatches. I hope this sharing helps you gain a more comprehensive understanding of PD fast charging and its interface applications, allowing your old devices to continue serving their purpose. If you have relevant experiences or have discovered better solutions, feel free to share them in the comments.